Morning, everyone. Good morning, everyone. Welcome to 267th meeting of Delhi One Toastmasters. We provide a supportive and positive learning experience in which members are empowered to develop communication and leadership skills, resulting in greater self-confidence and personal growth. Let me share the online meeting statement. By attending this remote area division, you agree to the privacy policy of Dell of Toastmasters International, as well as the unassociated remote hosting service. Some of your personal information, such as name, email, and any shared messages, may be shared with other meeting participants and will be recorded by Toastmasters International, who may use the recording in the future as it sees fit. Your remote attendance hereby discharges Toastmasters International from all claims, demands, rights, promises, damages, and liabilities arising out of or in connection with the use or distribution of said video recordings, including but not limited to any claims for invasion of privacy, appropriation of likeness, or defamation. Let me share rules of meeting. Mute yourself by clicking in the audio button when the speaker or any role player is speaking. Unmute only when it's your turn to speak. This will help to avoid distraction. There is a raise hand option at the screen below participants, which one can use if he or she wants to participate in table topics or listener or fun segment of the meeting. Please ask only Techmaster if you're audible or not, and Techmaster is me. And let me introduce the president of Delhi One Toastmasters, Toastmaster Anand Kumar. President Anand.
Thank you so much.
Thank you so much, Karthik.
Yes, please, Anand.
Yeah, thank you so much, Karthik. So, welcome everyone to meeting hashtag 267. I am your presiding officer, Anand Kumar, and you are here at the Delhi One Toastmasters Club of Toastmasters International. So, without wasting much time, I can see that there is a guest. I would like to have a quick introduction. So, Kanika is there. So Kanika, if you could let us know the quick things about you. First of all, because we can see your name, so we do know that. So what do you do and how do you came to know about our club and what you are looking forward to in this very particular club?
Yeah, thank you so much, Anand. My name is Kanika Garg, as you can see. And I've been part of TCS Maitri Gurgaon Toastmasters Club from past 1 year. And I'm also working at TCS from past 1 year as well. And yeah, I'm currently serving as VP membership there. And I'm looking forward to a great session here because I've heard a lot about Delhi One Toastmasters. So thank you. And I'm happy to be here. Thank you so much.
Nice seeing you over here, Kanika. Welcome to the Delhi One Toastmasters once again, and looking forward for your speech too. So, because there is no other guest, I would now like to actually ask you one question, or rather a tidbit, which is related to Toastmasters, of course. So, my question to you is that if you are in a pathways, so once you have chosen a path, you have bought a pathway, you have purchased a pathway, can that very pathway? And if you can, then why you can't? So anyone of you?
Anand, your voice is not coming.
Okay, so I will. If
Anand,
my
you
voice
can
is
repeat
not.
The question. Now your voice is audible.
So I will ask Sajal to take it over.
Good morning, everyone. Let's give a huge round of applause to ourselves as we meet on this refreshed Sunday morning. And today, I would like to invite somebody on stage who is ever shining and who is extremely innovative and curiously creative.
Okay. So I am saying in pathways, can you change your pathway after having purchased that? So if yes, it's fine. If you say no, then why not?
I don't know. No, we can't change the pathways as far as I know. Anyone else?
I think Anand is facing network issues as he
Yes, yes, he is disconnected. So, Sajal, please conclude the.
Yeah. So, without further ado and taking much of your time, I would like to invite Toastmaster Pooja on the stage so that we can witness a splendid performance today. Over to you, Toastmaster Pooja.
Thank you, Toastmaster Sajal. A very warm good evening, fellow Toastmasters and dear guests. After almost 1.5 week, now finally I am feeling better. Better from what? Actually, I was in a huge fear of COVID-19. No doubt, everybody has this fear at some level, but I was more. How? So today I want to share this experience and what I learned from it in this past week. Since 4th of this month, I started to feel some tiredness and weakness in my body. And I started to work upon it, that I will overcome it as soon as possible. But when 2 days passed and there is no sign of improvement in my situation, and I got fever also, then a little fear about getting COVID-19 built up in my mind. And further, 2 days passed and still the situation was same. And this time I also started to face the coughing problem. Then this fear became solid. And what happened next, I will share this in between the segments. Now, I will start to tell about our meeting structure. I learned 3 lessons in this period. That first, keep yourself healthy physically and mentally. Second, always keep ready your mind or body to face any kind of problems and challenges. And third, do prioritize your health and take care of yourself. And similarly, in this meeting, we have 3 kinds of segments. First, table topic session. Prepared history session. Second, table topic session. And third, evaluation session. In prepared session, our prepared speakers will deliver their prepared speeches. In second, it is impromptu session, that where speaker will get the topics on the spot, and so that they will build up their impromptu skills, quick speaking and thinking skills. And third is evaluation section, where our evaluator will provide their constructive feedback for the speaker's speech. And apart from these, we have also tag teams in our auxiliary role players, which also play a very critical role in our meeting. Tech teams mean timer, accounter, and grammarian. So let's start first from our auxiliary role players. And our first auxiliary role player is Timer, who will tell us the importance of time in our life. And our Timer is today Toastmaster Ankush Shrimali. So let's invite on this virtual stage our Timer of the day, Toastmaster Ankush Shrimali.
Thank you, Toastmaster of the day. Am I audible?
Yes, you are audible.
So, good morning, everyone. Today, I'm playing the role of Timer. As you can see my screen, I will be putting this clock in front of everyone so that everyone remembers that I will be the one who is going to show green card at the lower level, yellow card at the median level, and red card at the maximum time limit allotted for your role or your speech. I would also be noting down the individual segments timing. So I would request everyone to please be respectful of the time. And 30 seconds would be given as a grace period for all the segments. So thank you, and over to you, Toastmaster Ankur.
Thank you so much, Toastmaster Ankur. Now our next auxiliary role player is our counter, who will tell us about the importance of avoiding filler words in public speaking. And today, our accounter is Toastmaster Vikas. Let's invite our accounter of the day, Toastmaster Vikas. Over to Toastmaster Vikas.
Thank you, Toastmaster Pooja. Good morning, fellow Toastmaster and guests. My name is Vikas, and I am the accounter for the today's meeting. When we speak, we use some filler words such as or repeat phrases like you know, I mean. A lot of times, this is not evident to us, but it is very clear to the listener. A counter helps us polishing our language by identifying these filler words. And I will present my report when the general evaluator calls upon to do so. Thank you, Toastmaster.
Thank you, Toastmaster Vikas. And now, moving on, our next auxiliary role player, which is Grammarian. And today, Grammarian is Toastmaster Shreya Avasthi, and she will tell us the importance of grammar in our public speaking. So, welcome, Shreya. Over to you.
Thank you, Toastmaster of the day. Am I audible?
Yes, you are audible.
Okay, good morning, fellow Toastmasters and dear guests. My role as a language evaluator would be to pay attention to the good usage of English and provide constructive feedback for improvement. I would like to introduce the word of the day. The word of the day is laconic, which means to be brief or economically short or using few words. Synonyms include brief, concise, short. Example, as we have a stipulated time for our meeting, we all should keep our speeches and role descriptions laconic. You are encouraged to use the word as frequent as you could in the meeting. I will present my report at the end of the meeting. Thank you. Back to you, Toastmaster, today.
Thank you so much, Shreya. Now, big round of applause for all the auxiliary role players for their introduction. Now, we would begin our first segment of our meeting, which is prepared speech session. Like, we should always keep our body strong enough, and strong enough that we can overcome every kind of disease or challenges. Likewise, in this session, our speaker comes with their prepared speeches, and they deliver their speeches according to their speech objectives. And today we have two prepared speakers. So let's start from our first speaker. And first speaker is Toastmaster Kanika Garg. And before calling her on the stage, let's hear her speech objective from our speech evaluator, Toastmaster Santosh. Toastmaster Santosh, over to you.
Thank you, Toastmaster Pooja. Am I audible?
Yes, you are audible.
Okay, thank you. Good evening, everyone. Toastmaster Kanika will be delivering Project 1 of Level 3 from Innovative Planning Pathway. The purpose of this project is for the members to practice developing and presenting a proposal. The time allotted for the speech is 5 to 7 minutes. I wish all the best to the speaker. Thank you. Over to you.
Thank you, Toastmaster Santosh. Now, time to invite our first speaker, Toastmaster Kanika Daffodil. Daffodil Toastmaster Kanika.
You are on mute, Kanika.
Yeah, can you please confirm if I am audible properly?
Yes, you are audible.
Okay, thank you so much, Toastmaster Pooja. I wandered lonely as a cloud that wanders over high, over walls and hills, when all at once I saw a crowd, a host of golden daffodils. Did you all just see what I did there? That was how my first experience of public speaking went like. When my class teacher suddenly nominated me to recite the poem Daffodils in front of whole school assembly. And I am sure most of you have had your first experience almost as bad as mine. Unless you are born with the genes of public speaking. And I don't know if that statement is scientifically correct or not, but I do know the statistics. According to the National Institute of Mental Health, around 73% of the population suffers from public speaking anxiety, also known as glossophobia. So when I see these statistics, my first experience doesn't seem that bad. But it also tells me that public speaking is no piece of cake.
You got stuck.
Sorry?
Yeah, please continue.
It also tells me that public speaking is no piece of cake. But that doesn't mean that we shouldn't even try. And we should not try to become a world champion or TED speaker or something. Public speaking has so many benefits that you can't even ignore. It not just improves your communication skills, rather it gives you the confidence of being the best version of yourself, the one you have always aspired to become. It not just improves your chances of becoming a leader, but it gives you the idea of how to present your thoughts to someone, be it talking to the customer care service and explaining your problem to them, be it standing at the Domino's counter and explaining your specifications of the pizza, and even asking a girl or a boy out on a date. It can open so many gates and opportunities for you that you can't ignore. So today, I am going to propose 3 points which has helped me a lot in mitigating my fear of public speaking. So let's begin. Now, as Indians, the biggest hurdle that we face while public speaking is when we have to speak in English. We all see half of our confidence is lost when we are asked to speak in English. How many of you all, while chatting with your friend, and if you have to send a sentence in English, you first cross-check it on Google whether it is correct or not? How many of you have avoided in childhood that when your parents and teachers forced you to speak in English and you just can't? Why did that happen? Why are you so afraid of English? I think the problem lies in sentence formation. We are not able to translate our Hindi thoughts into English continuously and very fast. So today, I have 2 methods for you that can help you in making your sentence formation skills are a little better. The first and the most useful and the mainstream method is reading. Now, when I say reading, I know those big fat novels are coming to your mind. No, I'm not talking about them. Our main purpose here is to learn sentence formation. So I just say read anything. Read anything that sparks your interest. And while reading, note down those big and complex sentences that you have always find difficulty in forming. And read them aloud 2 to 3 times a day. Now, my second method is for those who, no matter how hard they try, are not able to read. So for them, I suggest consume as much content as you can in English. Watch English movies, watch listen to English series and podcasts. And if you're into sports, listen to English commentaries and mimic your favorite characters, your favorite dialogues, your favorite sentences out loud 2 to 3 times a day. You have to do this exercise. Now coming to my second point. Trust me, this point works like a magic. It has helped me a lot and it will help you a lot. Talk to yourself in front of the mirror. Talk about anything. Earlier, I used to be so underconfident about how am I looking, am I standing correct, am I giving out funny expressions to the audience, is my posture correct or not. But after practicing this exercise, I was able to work on my body language and expressions very easily. Just talk about anything. Make it a habit of yourself to talk about anything in front of the mirror. You can talk about yourself, your emotions. And if you're not finding anything, just use the method, cow method. I guess you know about, if you're not aware of the cow method, let me tell you. In this, you just pick a random thing. Like I start with cow. Cow is a pet animal. I think I'm not that kind of a pet person, but if I have to, I think I will choose dog. Just like that, you can link your thoughts that are coming to your mind and say it out loud in front of the mirror in English, of course. This helps you in impromptu speeches also. Now, coming to my last point, and of course not the least point. Don't try to be perfect on stage. You know, most people have it wrong. They think that being perfect will make people like them more. But I think it will make them dislike you more. If you talk about me, I like people who are more vulnerable and they should bring out their weaknesses and vulnerabilities without any shame and embarrassment. Can you think about the strength of those people? And today I am also going to tell you that please don't try to be perfect and don't try to compare yourself that you are going to do better than him or her. Now here, I'm not saying that don't try to be better. You should always do that. But your only competitor should be you only. So today, I challenge you guys to remove all those filters behind which you are hiding and bring out that real you who always wanted to become a public speaker. And bring out that virgin which is confident and carefree at the same time. And bring out that virgin who is able to recite the poem Daffodils without any fear. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much, Toastmaster Kanika, for such a very helpful speech. Now time to provide the feedbacks. Toastmaster Karthik, okay, the feedback link is in chat window. So please share your valuable feedback for the first speaker. Now, moving on, our next speaker, who is Toastmaster Arun. And before calling him on the stage, let's invite first his speech evaluator, Toastmaster Jyoti Kumari. Over to Toastmaster Jyoti.
Thank you, Toastmaster of the day, Toastmaster Pooja. The second speaker, Toastmaster Arun, will be delivering his Level 3, Project 3, from the Pathway Presentation Mastery Path. And the project is titled Connect with Storytelling. So the purpose of the project is for the member to practice using a story within a speech or giving a speech that is a story. The member completing the project is focusing on using stories in a speech or creating a speech that is a story. The member may use any type of story, which can be personal, which can be well-known fiction, or can be one of his or her own creation. All the best to the speaker, and over to the Toastmaster of the day.
Thank you so much, Toastmaster Jyoti. Now, time to invite our second speaker, Toastmaster Arun. Who is better, Toastmaster Arun?
Good morning to all of you. Is my sound clear?
Yes.
Two types of persons living in this world. First, the persons who are taking new initiatives. And second, the persons who are not taking new initiatives. The persons who are not taking any new initiatives, his life is very simple and peaceful. And he is not investing much money, much resources in their life. But the second person who are taking new initiatives are investing much money, much resources, and there are two possibilities. Either he will get the success or he will not get the success. So, see the story of MBT is extended Muhammad bin Tughlaq. Muhammad bin Tughlaq, MBT Mahajag.
Toastmaster Arun, your voice is breaking. It's not clear.
Try it
once again.
Okay, so is it clear now?
Better.
Okay, I'm continuing if you get or not. Doesn't matter, I will use my guide. So the thing is that Muhammad bin Tughlaq has initiated so many new things. First thing is that he has changed the capital from Delhi to Devagiri. The reason of changing this capital is that Delhi was in center and already focused to Mongolian attack. And in the second thing, the resources of South India has to exploit. Third thing is that Devagiri was very safe rather than Delhi. So the king did whatever he could do. Like he built the road from North India to South India and planted so many trees and built so many houses in the Devagiri in a proper and manner way. But this plan could not succeed. But because the migrated persons were basically from upper and middle class and queen classes. So, and there was an intimated and a very emotional attachment with Delhi. So this plan could not succeed. The meaning is that the implementation part was good, but the king must have focused more before making the policy. The second example is, he had started to introduce a symbolic plan, a symbolic coin. Symbolic coin because there was a crisis at that time of silver at the world level. But so the king thought that we should save the silver. So he has started a new coin and that is made by copper. But the king did not started any mechanism who could classify the coin of a state and the coins of the other public who were also doing this. So the economy was disrupted at very low condition. And finally, the king veto this policy. Meaning here is that the policy was good, but the implementation side was not good. Now, third thing is that he had started the more focused on cultivated area, that is the Meghalaya area. Here the king did whatever he could do, means scientific pattern of crops he did, and loan provided to the farmers, and many government funding had been invested in that area. Definitely the king would expect more revenue from that area. But this plan also not got success. Why? Because there was a natural disaster at that year. So here the policy was good, implementation was good, but the natural disaster was there. Means there was an adverse situation at that time. So generally when we make a policy, we generally make a policy and try to implement this. But we are not aware to what will be the effect of the policy in future. For example, if we allow any persons free of cost, free membership in DOTM, then everyone will come here. But since this plan is a very welfare manner and good initiative, but the purpose of DOTM may destruct. And if we keep a point that the persons who will get 5 points out of 10 in their first speeches, then the purpose of DOTM would be more better. Similarly, if there is a plan initiative in the Toastmaster International, and if first we try to initiate this in one or two clubs, and then after get the feedback from that club, we implement all over the club, then it would be more better. So important thing is here that since we are in a competitive age and we can't stop to our development. So thing is that how we could do better, and we have to choose which one is better. First, the first one who is not taking any initiatives and living a simple and peaceful life, or second who is doing so many initiatives, but there is a risk to failure in the systems or to get and achieve the goal. But in the second condition, if we use the better management, more focused before making the policy and the better implementation of policy, then definitely we can achieve this. So the thing is that which one is better, we have to think about this. And thank you, and over to Madam Toastmaster.
Thank you so much, Toastmaster Arun. Now, again, thanks to Vijik feedback link, and please provide your valuable feedback for the second speaker, Toastmaster Arun.
Feedback link is given in the chat box.
And also, Karthik, please launch the poll for the best.
Yes. Okay. Poll is launched. Please, everyone vote. You have 30 seconds to do so.
Karthik, I am not able to find feedback link in the chat.
Okay. I'm resending the feedback link. Can you see it right now?
Yeah, thank you.
Okay. Poll time is up. Please continue.
Thank you, Toastmaster Karthik. Now coming to my story, my fear about getting COVID-19 further increased when I came to know that in my department where I work, my one close friend was COVID positive. And I recall myself that I was having a lunch with him one day. It was 20 days earlier. So I immediately called him and asked him about his health. So he told me that he was totally fine. He was just lost his taste bud. So I found that it was asymptomatic. And I also found from the news that now COVID is asymptomatic too. So it was going too much in my head. And finally, I took it as a challenge that no matter I am COVID positive or not, I will work on it, and now I will take care myself, and I will recover from it. And with, the same one is about our next session, which is also about get rid out from our fear of public speaking. And this is also called impromptu session and table topic session. It helps us to our quick thinking and speaking skills improvement. And today I'm the table topic master, and I have some topics with me. And anyone who will would like to speak, then they will pick any number, and I will give them the topic. And each speaker will get 1 to 2 minutes on the stage, and timer will show the green card at 1 minute and yellow card at 1 minute, half second, 30 seconds, and red card at 2 minutes. And there will be 30 seconds of grace period only in upper side. So, and also remember the today the word of the day is laconic, and which is the meaning is brief and to the point. So try to use in your speeches as much as possible. So let's start this session, and I want to see who would show his or her courage to take the topic.
I would like to volunteer for table topics.
Thank you, Toastmaster Kartik. So please pick any number in 1 to 6.
Number 1.
Okay. So your topic is Corona is worse than a world war. Corona is worse than a world war. Toastmaster Kartik.
Thank you, Table Topic Master and MC. This pandemic of coronavirus, in which in India itself we are number 2, for which we should not be proud of. And the amount of casualty happened in all over the world. 100 years back, the same kind of pandemic happened. It was called Spanish flu. It happened in the at the end of First World War in 1918-1919. In the same manner, the 100 years back, millions of people was infected, and lakhs maybe or a million of people unfortunately have got shot in their life. So at that point of time, though it's more hazardous than World War I, still it was not considered as a more deadly than from about First World War. But due to the recent phenomenon of we don't fight, we just do diplomacy in the name of country's competition. And maybe this one, this pandemic is also due to the certain nonsense things. So I consider that due to the amount of loss happened in property, in life of the people, this is the more deadlier than any world war or war kind of thing happened. That's it from my end. Over to MC.
Thank you, Toastmaster Kartik. Next, we'll try Toastmaster.
I would like to try.
Oh, yeah. Okay, so our second speaker is Toastmaster Bhavya Jain. Please choose any number in between 2 to 6.
3.
Nice. Your topic is Corona cannot do anything to hygienic and healthy people. Corona cannot do anything to hygienic and healthy people. Toastmaster Bhavya.
Thank you, Pooja. So during this pandemic, we have all realized that it's very important to stay hygienic, like washing hands before eating or whenever you come from anywhere, keeping your shoes outside your home, and like social distancing. All these things are the key to good health and hygiene. So these things could have been inculcated in our lives much earlier, but this corona was like a wake-up call for most of the people, and they have inculcated these things in their life, and they would be practicing these things even when corona would go. So this is a really important message for everyone that good health and hygiene is the key to, like, it comes from hygiene by keeping your things clean around yourself. So if you keep, just maintain these things suggested by a government, like clean health and hygiene, I'm sure that to a great extent we would be able to save ourselves from corona. Along with it, we can practice healthy eating habits, like cooking fresh food made in our homes instead of eating from outside. Because how much ever the restaurants try, some the home-cooked food is of no match of the cleanliness there are practiced in restaurants. So eat healthy and take good tonics, like kadas, like people make at home. So they are also very important for staying healthy. So if all these practices are maintained, there are less chances of getting this virus. So my message to all is just stay healthy by maintaining hygiene and eating healthy.
Thank you so much, Toastmaster Bhavya. Okay, now next speaker will be
Shreya.
Please unmute yourself. Okay, so our next speaker is Toastmaster Shreya. So Shreya, please choose any number in between 1 to 6, except 1 and 3.
5.
5? Okay. So your topic is, if you are going through hell, keep going. If you are going through hell, keep going. Over to Toastmaster Shreya.
Thank you, Toastmaster, Table Topic Master Pooja. If you are going through hell, keep going. Well, it is correctly said, because being stuck over something is not that appropriate at that moment, because we all know that nothing can happen at that moment, neither right nor wrong. It's better to go and move on, just go with the flow. Whatever the, it is, we have all heard of, about a famous quote, nothing lasts forever, be it good or bad. So it's better to believe in yourself and hold on that faith that this will just pass. So just hold on and go with it with full courage, as I am going through a lot of bad times right now. And all I can say is to myself is, this too shall pass. I had my good days, now it's time for me to face my bad days, and then I'll again have good days. So right now we all are facing bad situations, a lot of frustration is going on, like sitting at our homes, work, not good work, or some have lost their jobs, some college students are facing problems. But every cloud has a silver lining, and just believe in God and believe in yourself. Love people around you and be united with your family, because no one stands for you but your family. So if even it is hell or heaven, nothing is permanent. So thank you. That's from my heart.
Thank you so much, Toastmaster Shreya, for your beautiful words. Timer, do we have more time for one speaker?
Yeah, one more speaker.
So, would you like to try?
You can ask someone else.
Okay. Toastmaster.
I can be the timer, Ankur, if you want to go for
it. Yes.
Yeah,
Yeah, Pooja, you can give me one.
Okay, so our next speaker is Toastmaster Ankur. Ankur, please choose any number in 2, 4, or 6.
4.
So your topic is say namaste to others and stay safe. Say namaste to others and stay safe. Toastmaster Ankur.
To tabletoping master. So the point of being safe in COVID times is to maintain social distance by having proper hygiene, wearing masks, gloves, using sanitizers, and keeping a safe distance from people. Earlier, people used to think that the way we greet people tell us how warmly we are making them feel and how welcoming we are trying to make them. But these days, the best way to make them comfortable as well as welcoming is by maintaining a proper distance and giving a normal gesture of a smile or a namaste or a high five or some greetings which are contactless. In times of corona, it is very important for us to understand that this is not a situation where we should be social and be close to each other. We should be close emotionally but not physically. Keeping a distance will not only save you yourself but also others from you if you are carrying the germs. So I feel that be it a namaste or a salam or any gesture which you use in your daily life can be used for others as well. And I read it somewhere that how you greet your ward, you do not touch them, of course you touch their feet, but you do not touch them directly to greet. Similarly, you can treat others as well as basic human. You can treat everyone as a figure of God and show the respect to them by also allowing them to be safe from you and from others. So that's the gist what I got from the topic. Over to you, tabletop.
Thank you so much, Toastmaster Ankur, and a big round of applause for all the tabletop speakers. And Toastmaster Karthik, please launch the poll for the best tabletop speaker.
Yes, poll is launched. Everyone, please vote. You all have 30 seconds to vote. All right, polling is closed. You may proceed, MC.
Okay, thank you, Toastmaster Karthik. So when I started to accept this challenge, and so I started to take care of myself with the home remedies. Like I took gilhoi juice, kadha, lukewarm water in every 15 minutes, herbal tea, vitamin C, and turmeric milk, and also healthy diet to boost my immunity. I started to feel better. And similarly, our next session is the evaluation session where our evaluator provides their feedback, constructive feedback for the speaker's speech. And if our speaker takes their points to improvement, and if they implement, then they also learn or better, they becomes better public speaker. So our next session, which is going to held by Toastmaster Sajjal, who will proceed this meeting So let's welcome our general evaluator for the day, Toastmaster Sajjal. Over to Toastmaster Sajjal.
Thank you so much, Toastmaster Pooja. Let's have a huge round of applause for our MC and our table topic master, Toastmaster Pooja. Do you know what is the shortest word that could be formed from the letters A, B, C, D, E, F using all the letters? The answer is feedback, and it is one of the most essential elements of any communication. General evaluation is the most critical section in a Toastmasters meeting, as it shows us not just where we did wrong, but also how we can improve upon it. In Toastmasters, we follow a sandwich approach, which is also known as CRCS approach, a commendation, recommendation, commendation, and a summary approach, in which we, the positives are fitted in between the negatives. And we also give, it's always good to provide a brief summary at the end of the evaluation, as it gives a glimpse to the speaker as to where he or she could improve and where he or she did commendable. So we always get a bit of less time while evaluating, so it's better to be laconic at it. And there are three sections in the evaluation section. The first section is in which the speech evaluators come and present their reports according to the objectives given by Toastmasters International. The second section is in which the auxiliary role players come and present their reports. And the third is the overall evaluation of the meeting. So firstly, let's begin with the speech evaluation section. I would like to call upon the stage Toastmaster Santosh, who will be evaluating Toastmaster Kanika's speech. Over to you, Toastmaster Santosh.
Am I audible and visible?
Yes, you are.
Yes. Okay. Thank you. Good morning once again. Today, the Toastmaster Kanika delivered her project 1 of level 3, which was titled as Daffodils. What I really liked about the Toastmaster speech, the first is the opening. The opening was very, very creative, because she has mentioned that how we all, in starting, when we start the public speaking, we fumbled. So I really comment on that. She has also mentioned about the data, that how many percentage of people are suffering from this public speaking. And she has also mentioned that how she has come out from this fear. So from all this, she has proposed a wonderful proposal on the public speaking, as well as she has mentioned about the problem. The first problem was that the sentence formation. And she has also provided the practical solution like reading. Not only novels, but anything you can read. And if someone is not able to, if anybody not take interest much in reading, they can consume, like they can watch movies in English and listen English music and many more. Another problem she has mentioned, that the people try to be perfect in everything, but it is not a solution. So try to be compete to yourself, not the others. So I really like that the speaker has clearly proposed the proposal, and she has explained the practical examples and the solutions to this particular proposal. I have few recommendations for the speaker. The first is, I couldn't understand that the title of the speech with the speech content. But in the starting, it was matching that she has told us the story, poem of Daffodils. So the title should be easy, and so that the audience can understand that. Another recommendation is on voice modulation. There are a lot of points on which the speaker could have focused on the voice. Like when she was mentioning that 73% data, there are 73% of people are suffering from the public speaking. So it was, it could be the waking call for all of us that how much data is there. Another thing is that, another recommendation on the stays moment, there are three problems. So she could divide it like this is first, second, and third. So she could use the virtual stays. Overall, I really loved the speech because the problem was very common and we all can correlate. And I can correlate it very well because still I'm facing this problem. If she could work on the voice modulation and the stage movement, that the speech could be much more better. So that's all from my side. I wish all the best to the speaker for further speeches. Over to you, Sajal Jain.
Thank you so much, Toastmaster Santosh, for a wonderful evaluation. Next, I would like to invite Toastmaster Jyoti, who will be evaluating Toastmaster Arun's speech. Over to you, Toastmaster Jyoti.
Thank you, Madam General Evaluator. The speaker, Toastmaster Arun, today delivered a speech which was titled, Who is Better? And from the title itself, the audience's attention was engaged on what the speaker is. Title was interesting, and it also did not reveal a lot about what the speech was based on. So I think the speaker did a very good job on that part. Coming to the speech structure, which was presented by the speaker, the flow of the speech was very easy to follow, and there were a lot of examples from different forms of different parts of life. Like there was example from history, there was example from governance, and it was also relevant to the audience here today because there was a component of management of DOTM meetings also included by the audience, included by the speaker. So I think the speaker did a very good job on that. And in the end, the speaker had a takeaway in which the speaker did not answer the question, who is better, but the speaker left it for the audience and told the audience that it is for them to decide on the basis of the situation. So that part of the speech was done very well. I would recommend the speaker to incorporate two feedbacks into his speech, because the speech was basically on storytelling. One of the best tips which I have received is in storytelling is to show and not to tell. You have to show the story to the audience and not tell the story, because showing the story engages the audience's attention. It builds up attention, it reaches to a climax, and then it gives an ending to the story. So I'll tell the speaker how it can be incorporated into the speech. The speaker gave when he was giving the example of Muhammad bin Tughlaq and the three decisions he took, he told the audience the decision first. And then he said what led to the decisions. The speaker can build up the tension by saying what the situation was earlier. Like Delhi was facing Mongoloid attacks and this empire was expanding in the south. There was a need to move the capital. And then the speaker can say that Muhammad bin Tughlaq did move the capital from Delhi to Daulatabad and it failed. So the tension rises, the audience can follow up the story much better, and the audience stays with the story as the story progresses. One thing I would like the speaker to challenge himself on is the pace of the speech. The speaker had a very fluent delivery, but there were points at which there was pauses required, like when he moved from one idea to the other, when he moved from one problem of Muhammad bin Tughlaq to the other. So incorporating these two points into his speech of showing the audience what the story is and of adding a little bit pauses when the transition is being made will take the speaker to a much higher level. And congratulations to the speaker for completing this project. Over to the general evaluator.
Thank you so much, Toastmaster Jyoti, for such an informative evaluation. Next, let's hear it out from our auxiliary role players. First, I would like to invite Toastmaster Shreya, who was the language evaluator for our today's meeting. Over to you, Toastmaster Shreya.
General evaluator, Toastmaster Sajal. Am I audible?
Yes, you are audible.
Fellow Toastmasters, it was a pleasure listening to all of you. I did find a good, excellent use of English. Toastmaster Kanika said born with the genes of public speaking. We learned a new term, glossophobia, which means fear of public speaking. Idiom used was piece of cake, wake up call by Toastmaster Bhavya. Phrases used were nothing lasts forever and every cloud is a silver lining by me. Word used was mitigating, which means lessening the gravity of a mistake or an offense. Toastmaster Arun, you mentioned some work of Muhammad bin Tughlaq, that he built houses and plant trees and did that. I would suggest you to use "and" when needed. Like you could have said, he built houses, planted trees and did that. So that would have been better. Just try to make your speech a little bit laconic, which you can do by using less filler words like "and." Statement I liked, which said by Toastmaster Sajal, was positives is fitted into negatives. Meanwhile, I'm not quite happy by the use of word of the day, which was only used by Toastmaster Sajal. That's all from my report. Back to you, Toastmaster Sajal.
Thank you so much, Toastmaster Shreya. Next, I would like to invite Toastmaster Vikas on stage, who was the R counter for today's meeting. Over to you, Toastmaster Vikas.
Thank you, Toastmaster Sajal Jain. Toastmaster of the day, Pooja Yadav. Spoke four times or three times "um," and her favorite word was "and." And in auxiliary role player, Ankur Shirimali did not use any filler words. Shreya did not use any filler word. And in speech segment, Toastmaster Kanika used word repetition when you I guess him or her. And Toastmaster Arun Kumar did not use any filler word. And in speech evaluation section, Toastmaster Santosh Devi used two times "a," and there was two word repetition, "very, very," and "there are 73% people," two times. And second speech evaluator, Jyoti Kumari, used three times "a" and did not use any more filler words. And in table topics section, Toastmaster Karthik used one time "a," and Bhavya used three times "a," and Shreya used one time "a." And table topic master Pooja Yadav used four times "a" and two times "um," and her favorite word was "and." That's from my side. Thank you, Toastmaster Sajal Jain.
Thank you so much, Toastmaster Vikas. Let's hear it out from our timer of the day, Toastmaster Ankur. Over to you, Toastmaster Ankur.
Thank you so much, Madam General Evaluator. As per today's meeting, all the speakers and role players were quite laconic in their respective roles and speeches. As per the agenda, we should be on 11:40, but we are 6 minutes ahead of our schedule. But there were few role players and speakers who did cross the time limit, so let me narrate it to you. Our Sergeant at Arms took 2 minutes against 2 minutes 30 seconds, so well within time. President Anand, despite having few technical challenges and then having to and fro with Toastmaster Sajal, crossed the limit to 4 minutes and 24 seconds as against 3 minutes allotted. Our MC Pooja, in the introduction, used 3 minutes and 9 seconds against 2 minutes allotted. Our counter, Toastmaster Vikas and Toastmaster Shreya, both were within time limits in the introduction of their roles. So the first speaker, Toastmaster Kanika, exceeded the time limit. She used 8 minutes and 4 seconds as against the speech of 7 minutes. Toastmaster Arun used exactly 6 minutes as against 7 minutes of speech. In the table topic section, all the speakers were well within time. In the speech evaluation section, Toastmaster Santosh used 3 minutes 42 seconds exceeding the time limit of 3 minutes provided. Toastmaster Jyoti used 3 minutes and 13 seconds, so well within time of if including the grace period of 30 seconds. In the reports of Ogli role players, Toastmaster Shreya used 1 minute and 30 seconds as against 3 minutes. So the minimum allotted time was 2 minutes. So she said that she is disappointed with the use of word of the day. She could have used the time to explain more or giving more examples of the word of the day. So our counter, Toastmaster Vikas, used 2 minutes and 13 seconds, so within the time. And I have used 2 minutes and 27 seconds. So over to you, Madam General Evaluator.
Thank you so much, Toastmaster Ankur. So now it's time for the overall report of the entire meeting. I would like to begin with the Sergeant in Arms. I would really like to commend Toastmaster Karthik's efforts, as he is the first one in the morning to message that please join in the meeting. And he was super energetic, and he had a conversation with guests as well. Coming to President of the Day, Toastmaster Anand always brings out a fresh perspective to the meeting, and he had prepared some interesting tidbits for us too. Due to adjusting to the new normal, he was facing network issues. One little recommendation I had for him was to have a prepared introduction for the MC or the Toastmaster of the Day. Coming to our MC, Toastmaster Pooja, she had a perfect introduction today about her role. And she had a perfect eye contact, which shows the level of preparedness that she had done for the role. There was hardly a lack of slip-ups in communication skills. She had the speech titles ready. And one thing that could be done would be the recommendation about the introduction about recommendation. One recommendation would be to have a proper introduction of the speaker. Even though we didn't have a theme today, I didn't feel that there was a lack of connect in the meeting. And Toastmaster Pooja beautifully crafted the entire meeting, and she gave us a very relatable and personal story as how she overcame the fears of COVID. And one thing that she could have done was that she could relate it to the fears of table topic speaking as well, that how when she overcame the fear of COVID, that we can overcome our fear of public speaking through table topic section. The table topics she prepared was in sync with what is happening with the world right now, and they were very relatable. So that was a fantastic idea that Toastmaster Pooja used. And the word of, she even told the word of the day to use the word of the day in the table topic section, which is always a great idea as it helps us to listen to that word of the day more, and it helps us to engage in that segment more. Coming to our auxiliary role players, Toastmaster Ankur, for timer of the day, I absolutely love that the icon was showing a watch. So whenever a guest or somebody joins late, he or she immediately knows what the red, green and yellow cards mean, as it is related to time. And one recommendation would be that the grace period about the table topics could have been mentioned in the introduction section, that there is no grace period of 30 seconds in the table topic section in the below limit. I really liked the one thing in his report, that he used the words exceeding or the words as against as, instead of using the words disqualified, which makes the report a bit more empathetic. And it's always a good idea. And I think we can all learn from that we can avoid using the word disqualified. Coming to Toastmaster Vikas, the introduction was perfect, as he explained the role perfectly, and he told us not just where we are lacking, but he also told us as why it acts as a hindrance to our communication skills. and his report was laconic. So kudos Toastmaster Vikas. Coming to Toastmaster Shreya, she had a very great, good choice of word of the day. I guess it wasn't used more because since we had a shorter period of time and maybe due to that, but it was a good use of the day. And she even reiterated the word of the day indirectly in her report when she said that she was asking Toastmaster Vikas that the report could be laconic. Then coming to the speech evaluation section, this for the speaker one, Toastmaster Kanika, I found the speech very relatable because we all have suffered through that, like we still have fear for public speaking. And the language she used, that piece of cake, was commendable. I really liked Toastmaster Sanju's commendation that she had a very strong opening to the speech. And whenever you have a strong opening, that immediately grabs the attention of the audience to make them hooked, to make them listen to the entire speech. So one recommendation for the speaker that I think might have been included was that the speech was a bit fast. So if the speaker could give time to the audience to absorb those ideas of the speech, it would make the speech more engaging. And it was a very genuine take on public speaking. Coming to Toastmaster Arun, it was a well-prepared and well-researched speech. And one recommendation was that I think the microphone was echoing, so that was the problem with the communication in his speech. And I saw that the hand gestures were very visible in his speech, but the speaker could make a better use of the hand gestures according to the content on his speech. One thing that I really liked about Toastmaster Jyoti's that she covered the mysterious aspect, that the open-endedness nature of the speech, that how Toastmaster Arun left it to the audience to how they want it to be interpreted. And she covered the basic essence of storytelling in just four words, that show it, not tell it. And overall, it was a very fun meeting, and it's true that we never know how a Toastmasters meeting will turn out to be. And today also it surprised us, as it was a very lighthearted and a fun-filled meeting. So back to our Toastmaster Pooja, our MC for the day's meeting.
Thank you, Toastmaster Jen. Big round of applause for her beautifully conducting this session. Thank you, Toastmaster Jen. Now, time to vote. Karthik, please launch the poll for firstly, for the evaluator.
Yes, please everyone vote. For you all have 30 seconds to do so. All right. And for next poll, MC, should I launch the next poll?
Yeah, sure. It is for the best OB role player.
Yes. Please everyone vote for best auxiliary role player.
Karthik, is it done?
Yes, it's done.
Thank you so much.
Yes. Please continue.
So, again on my story, that I was about to go visit a doctor, but I started to feel better. Then I dropped the plan. So I want to say everyone that in this pandemic, it is extremely important to not to panic. Instead of this, we should act wisely and calmly. As our Prime Minister also gave a slogan that jab tak dawai nahi tab tak dhilai nahi. means no carelessness till a medicine is found. And with this, I would like to hand over this stage to our current president, Toastmaster Anand. Over to Toastmaster Anand.
Anand is not here, so I'll take over. I would request the Tech Master to please launch the poll for best role player.
Yes, please everyone vote for best role players. You all have 30 seconds to do so.
Thank you. And I would like to thank all the role players, speakers, evaluators, auxiliary role players for participating in the meeting and making this meeting a great success. So I would like to ask Toastmaster Kanika to please give a feedback for our club and how she liked our meeting.
Thank you so much. I really loved the meeting. Actually, really, I'm happy to be here, and I'm happy that I gave a speech here because this topic was really close to my heart. And that's why I think I maybe exceeded the limit because I had so much content. And I really loved the session today, especially of Toastmaster Pooja. She shared a personal story, and I think it is happening, guys. COVID anxiety is real, and I know many of my friends who are facing this right now. And she shared how she fought with this, and I think we all can take some lesson from her. So thank you so much for having me. Thank you
Master Kanika for joining us. It was a pleasure to hear a speech from you and to be a part of this meeting. Hope to see you again in some other meetings as well. So, are the results ready?
Yeah, just 1 minute.
Thanks.
Karthik, can you make me the co-host?
Yes, I'm making you a co-host. Yes, you are the co-host. Bhavya, please continue.
Yeah, it is showing host disabled participant screen share.
Okay. Let me change the settings. Yes, you can share it.
Best speaker, Bhavya, who got
it? The best speaker goes to Toastmaster Kanika. Congratulations, Kanika.
Thank you, everyone.
Thank you for being part of this meeting. The best role player award goes to Toastmaster Pooja. Congratulations.
Thank you.
The best evaluator goes to Toastmaster Santosh. Congratulations. And also,
thank you, Bhavya.
She's not here. The best table topic speaker goes to Toastmaster Shreya. Congratulations, Shreya. The best auxiliary role player goes to Toastmaster Ankur Shrimali. Congratulations, Ankur. Thank you, Sajal, for sharing the results. I would request you all to turn on your videos for a group fee.
Is the best role players announced?
Yes, it was announced in the beginning.
Okay. Everyone, please show number one.
Yeah. One for Delhi, one to Smart.
Could you have to switch off your virtual vacuum if possible? Done.
Thank you. Everyone. I would request you all to please renew your membership by 18 September. And that's all. I thank you so much, everyone, for joining this meeting. Hope to see you in Friday's meeting as well. So signing off. Thank you so much.